We are under the lights this evening as we get you set for another edition of Baseball on the Show. It's Game 4 of the World Series between the Minnesota Twins and the Los Angeles Dodgers. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to the World Series here on the show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots of storylines here as we approach the start of Game 4.
Well, I can't help but be impressed with the way these guys have come into this series and just flat out handled their business. They're hitting on all cylinders, and I don't want to fully count out the other guys, but if the last three games are any indication of how this will play out, I think this series could be over really quick.
The buildup to this one is just about over. It's time for all the drama of World Series Baseball on the show. And we'll have it for you next. Clayton Kershaw gets the ball with a world championship on the line. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, Clayton Kershaw, he just breathes different air than everybody else. The best pitcher in the game of baseball. Good fastball, good changeup, good cutter, and a terrific curveball. When you think about the Cy Young Award, he's always in the mix. He's good, he's strong, he's left-handed, and he's quite simply one of the greatest pitchers of all time.
To short. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away.
Batting second, the third baseman, number 24, Josh Donaldson.
So one away here with the bases empty, and here's Donaldson. Bases are empty, one man out. It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. But it bends just foul into the second deck. A little chilly, but not unbearable tonight. 55 degrees here at first pitch. Broken bat as this ball's hit on the ground. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first to take care of him, and Kershaw's in control now, two away.
Batting third, the designated hitter, Nelson Cruz.
Here's a pitch swung on and missed, one and two now.
You could tell right there that curveball had some serious depth to it. That's what separates the good ones from the bad ones, that nasty spin rate, get that downward action. You even get a star player like this swinging at something in the dirt.
On the ground to third, gloved by Turner. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that they'll end the inning. Twins are set down 1-2-3. And now the Dodgers get a crack at it. No score. Rich Hill will be on the mound for Game 4. Dan, any thoughts?
Well, when you think of Rich Hill, there's one thing you think of. Power curveball. Has one of the best left-handed curveballs in the game of baseball. He'll throw it early, he'll throw it often, and he'll throw it any time in the count. His velocity isn't that bad either. He can get it up to 93, 94, but when you walk up there in a box against Rich Hill, you have one thing in mind. Try to hit that curveball.
And And he takes ball four. So the leadoff man is on here in the home half of the first in a scoreless ball game.
Man, the pitcher's wondering how he didn't get that call. Busted him inside on a 3-1 count, and the ump thought it was just a tad off the plate. Tough to get the benefit of the doubt from the umpire when you fall behind in a count like that, though.
Betts aboard here at first with nobody out. And it's 1-2.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. Stepping into the box, Max Muncy. Runners on first with one down. Runner goes for second. Pitch outside. The throw, not in time. He's in there at second.
Good steal of second there, and that really sets up the middle of this order to drive in a run and break this scoreless ball game. Always great if you can score first early in the game.
It's two balls and two strikes now.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
2-2.
We got three balls and two strikes.
You would think in this situation, maybe with a base open, he'd just pitch around him and put him on first. But not with the guy in the on-deck circle. He's going to attack this hitter.
And it's fouled away. Another payoff pitch. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Down the third baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Now the payoff pitch home. Hit out towards second, and that'll get by into center field for a base hit. The run comes across to score, and they jump ahead 1-0.
Boy, what a battle there, D'Lo. Several hits at bat right there. He threw everything but the kitchen sink, and he was still able to get an RBI base hit.
And, Dan, I can't tell you, the longer the ABs go, usually, I'll tell you, you get in that swing mode where if he throws the rosin bag, you're pulling the trigger on it. Wait for him to settle in his zone and not come outside of it and end up getting a knock.
Now the 1-1 pitch. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. As a look, now the pitch. Pulled toward right center field. Long run for the center fielder. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Batting fifth, the designated hitter.
So the runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and that'll bring up A.J. Pollock. Next pitch will be number 24 in this long first inning. Called strike, and that'll run it full.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And set up behind the dish is Eric Summersgill, as you see the rest of the umpiring crew there.
You know what, Dan? I'm always baffled when Eric Summers goes behind the dish because he has a tendency to favor.
Meanwhile here, this is going to be trouble out there in left center as it ought to be good for extra bases. And the score is the runner from first. It's a 2-0 ball game. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given a chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
So now to the plate, PK Hernandez. Loud contact there, but it's well fouled.
He got the fastball where he wanted and just pulled off.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. And the 29th pitch of the inning is swung on and missed, and that'll finally end it. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. We'll move ahead to the top of the second now. It's the Dodgers 2 and the Twins nothing. Ready now, Eddie Rosario. He'll get us started in the top of the second.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs, but it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
And he pumps the fastball by him here. 1-2 now. Well struck down the right field line. But this will land foul as he didn't miss by much. The 1-2. Gets him swinging. He struck him out.
Wow, that's the case right there where a pitcher knows this guy's up there and he's in swing mode. That pitch wasn't even close to the strike zone, and he still swung it.
Into the box, Eury Adrianza. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And the slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. Now the 3-2 pitch. Slow roller, left side. And there are two away now.
That is good.
And with two away now, let's take another look at our playoff brackets. And of course, the question on everybody's mind, will we crown a champion here tonight? The 1-1. And he fouls this one off. Two out, nobody on. Two and two now with two away and the base is empty. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Another 2-2 offering. Byron Buxton would be next. Fouled away. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And that one's taken outside for a ball. They walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Buxton ahead in the count, three balls and a strike.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. And he misses again. Ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
He did not want to let the hitter off the hook with two outs. And now he's got a runner in scoring position to deal with.
So it's first and second with two men gone. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Max Kepler. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Fouled off. Fouled away. We'll try again. 1-2.
Well, I think that pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it, but it just ended up taking off on him.
Here now the 2-2.
You can certainly tell at bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher, but you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Line toward right center. That gets down and the inning will continue. And the runner will score from second. Now the relay home, and he's safe.
You know, D-Row, even though we're early in this one, being down by two, that's a huge base hit to tie things up.
Yeah, this offense won't quit, Dan. They're going to give their pitcher every chance. They were able to fight back and get it back to even. We got a new ball game on our hands.
Stepping in now, Mitch Garver. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now.
Good spot for an RBI. Put the ball in play with the runner in motion. He could score all the way from first.
Ready to deliver the full count pitch. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. Got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts an end to the inning. So it's two runs on one hit, no errors, and one man left on. On now to the bottom of the second, and we are tied 2-2. Swung on and chopped up the middle, reined in. Throw on to first in time, one away.
Batting it. The catcher, Will Smith.
So digging in now, Will Smith, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. One out, nobody on. pulls this one in the air out to left. On the move is Rosario. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning.
Batting ninth, the second baseman, number nine.
So coming to the plate, Gavin Lux will try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. The 1-1 home. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Scooped up, they'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Some of our nation's young minds and future leaders here in attendance. Yikes. Back with more of Game 4 on the show after this. Back to the top of the order now, and that'll bring in Jorge Polanco to hit next. This one's blooped out toward right center field. And that'll get down for a base hit.
Well, that's what's so disappointing as a pitcher, D-Row. You make a really good pitch, and yet this guy's so big and so strong, he's able to muscle it into right field for a base hit.
Yeah, you hand your batting gloves to the first base coach right there, and you thank your lucky stars. That's a nice AB.
Digging in now, Josh Donaldson. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result. That's his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they could certainly roll too.
Chopper foul. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. And that'll bring up the big stick of Nelson Cruz. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Now the 1-1 pitch. Two offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
That's a great take right there. Great pitch recognition to let that one go. Opposite handed, that's coming across the plate. You might think you got a shot to stay inside that one.
Runner at first here with one away in a 2-2 ball game. Kershaw can't find the target there as he's run it as far as it can go now. It's 3-2.
Got to execute a good pitch right here. Runner at first is probably going to be on the move, and you got one of the better hitters on their team up at the plate.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And foul, though it had the home run distance. And he looks at one that misses, and that's an excellent job of making his man throw a lot of pitches as he toughs out a walk.
Well, he's really laboring in the early going here. That's his third walk of the game already. We'll see if he can get it together or if this is just one of those days where he's going to have to grind his way through this start.
Striding in, Eddie Rosario. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
That's a good take on a fastball out of the zone. Hey, I get it. He's looking for a ball to drive, but that ball was a little bit too far up in the zone. That's one you normally pop right up.
This will hang just long enough for him to run it down in shallow right for the second out. But they'll just get the one out here as the runner will get back safely at first. Two men on, two out, and A-Ray Adrianza will be the next to bat. Two down, runners at first and second. Called strike two, and now it's full 3-2. Ready with the payoff pitch. Fly ball into straightaway left. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Twin strand a pair. Home half of the third coming up, all even at 2-2. Bottom of the inning now, and that'll bring forth the veteran outfielder, Mookie Betts. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. The pitch. Left side of the infield into the shift. Fielded cleanly, and an off-balance throw is in time as he takes one away. Wow. Into the box, Corey Seager. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs where you get completely fooled. Look for him to be on the attack early in the setback.
A ball and two strikes now. Bases are empty, one man out. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. And right into the shift, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Now Corey with a swing and a deep drive to right. And that one is gone. A solo home run for Corey Seager. His first homer here in the series, and it's given the Dodgers a 3-2 lead.
Well, there's nothing that makes you feel as helpless as a ball like this. The pitcher and the right fielder were wishing and hoping it would hook foul right of the pole, but no such luck. Off the foul pole and gone.
In now, Max Muncy. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball.
He was able to sneak that fastball by him on 3-1, so now we've got a battle on our hands.
3-2 pitch. And he fouls this one off. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. In the air out to center field. Buxton is camped under this one. Two gone.
Now batting the center fielder, Cody Bellinger.
So bases are empty here with two gone, and that brings in the former National League Rookie of the Year, Cody Bellinger. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. And this one bounds around against the wall. And he'll coast into second here with a two-out double.
Man, it looked like the pitcher was trying to get him to go fishing in a pitch out of the strike zone. He went for it all right, but he managed to catch all of that baseball, lacing it for a double in the outfield. That's a great piece of hitting.
At the plate, A.J. Pollock. And that one got a piece of him.
Whoa, he looks a little frustrated out there, and I don't blame him. He gives up a couple of hits early inning, and then he plunks this guy. He's fighting himself a little bit, so they might want to head out to the mound and try to calm him down.
Next for the Dodgers, Kike Hernandez. Two on, two out for him here in the third. The set and the 1-1. And this one's in the dirt. Runners may have thought about it, but they'll stay put, and the count moves to 2-1. Two men are on with two men out. 2-2.
Hey, I'd like to see a little bit more discipline than that. You get a count in your favor and swinging a pitch that bad? Not good.
2-2. Here it is. This one sinks low and a touch outside. It's a full count, 3-2.
For the guy on the mound, this is one of those innings where nothing comes easy. He's thrown a bunch of pitches, and this AB hasn't been any different. Definitely laboring at the moment.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Fouled away. He set the 3-2. Hard hit ball to second. Throw to first in time, and the big inning is avoided as the side is retired. One for the Dodgers on the solo home run. We played three full, and Los Angeles has taken a 3-2 lead. Start of the fourth upcoming, but first, Heidi Watney standing by with a report.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Twins to discuss his thoughts on Minnesota's lineup so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats.
They've already worked out three walks, so he feels as though that kind of willingness to let the opposition work themselves into trouble will continue to result in good things for them on the scoreboard.
All right, thanks, Heidi. All set for the start of the inning, and digging in is the big-time power threat, Miguel Sano. And he checks his swing. Did he go around? Yes, says the first base umpire. Strike two. The 1-2. Misses for the second ball. Hit well on the ground to first. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball.
Hey, that pitch was nasty right there. He couldn't have done any more with that. For him to get a knock on this pitch right here, pretty special.
At the plate now, Byron Buxton. Swing and a miss, strike two.
Great pitch in that situation. If he makes contact on that one, more than likely he's hitting into a double play.
On its Taylor made to short, six. To second for one, relay throw, but it'll be too late as he's well safe at first.
And kids, this is why you always go hard into second base. Could have been an easy double play ball, but the slide really impacts the throw to first, and they wind up only getting one out on the play. Good, aggressive, legal slide that time.
Max Kepler the next to grab a bat. He was able to plate two with a base hit in his first appearance. Has a look, now the pitch. In there, now the throw. He is not in time. Pretty close, but he got in there safely.
Some managers treat the postseason as a time to be aggressive, and that's exactly the case here. They had the speed burner on the move, and it worked out nicely for him. Just got to drive him in now.
We're in the fourth. 3-2 is our score. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Another 1-2 delivery. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. Here now the 2-2.
Well, I think this is the kind of approach they need against such a prolific starter. You can't count on putting up a lot of runs, so getting him out of the game has to be the priority. Working at bats, full counts, running up the pitch count is a great way of doing that.
Grounded back up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Bellinger's got it. And not in time as he just crosses the plate in time.
Hey, with that base hit right there, D-Row, that's his third RBI that ties things up.
Yeah, 100%. He's had a great approach all game. Tied the ball game up with his third RBI knock, and he's looking for more.
Standing in now, Mitch Garver. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire. Ball two. The 2-1 home. Fouled off. Hits are now even at four apiece. Fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
In a double play situation, you kind of expect most pitches to be down in the zone, hoping for a ground ball. So that was an interesting pitch selection to go up in the zone. I think he caught him off guard a little bit.
So now to the plate, Jorge Polanco. Line drive to left. Hernandez is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Twins get a run on two hits. To the bottom of inning number four we go, and we are all tied at three apiece. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth, but before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Matt, during the break, I caught up with Dave Roberts, the Dodgers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And overall, he's really happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've been able to push across three runs to this point, but they've also made the opposition work extremely hard. He's thrown a lot of pitches, and they think they're going to have a good opportunity to push across a lot more runs as he tires or as they get into that bullpen.
All right, thanks, Heidi. Stepping up to the plate, Justin Turner. He's set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch.
Nope.
Hey, pretty aggressive pitch right there up in the zone. Surprised he didn't offer at it.
The 2-2. Turner swings, and it's a very well-hit ball to left. And gone! An absolute bomb. So a solo shot down the line in left. His first homer so far in the series as they take the lead 4-3.
Hitting a home run in the World Series is special at any point. Hitting a home run in the World Series that gives your team the lead, that's something to tell the grandkids about.
Stepping in now, Will Smith. Tried to bury one down and away, but it's a full count now, 3-2.
Well, it's been a rough one so far. 4 runs through 3 innings. It's about time to get that pitch count down, or he won't be out here very long.
4 runs, 5 hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. And it's fouled away. The next 3-2. Drilled to the left side. That's through for a base hit, and he's 1-for-2 now.
Dan, how hard is it to massage your way through such a deep lineup? I mean, even the 8-9 ball hitters are solid big league players.
You know, Mark, these days you're not seeing a lot of defensive specialists in the infield or outfield. If you're in that starting lineup these days, there's a pretty good job you can swing the bat.
And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. Working for the punch out and the offering.
So you'd love for him to offer at that one, but the execution was flawless. Nice curveball that starts in the zone and breaks just out. Just a great take by the batter.
The 2-2. A bouncer up the middle. Reined in. Step on the bag for one. On to first to complete the double play.
Good pitch on the ground ball there, and an even better job up the middle to take it himself and turn two. Pretty smooth.
So base is empty now after the double play, and coming forward the veteran outfielder Mookie Betts. Fastball on the inner third, taken for a strike. Two out, nobody on. That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
Good job to lay off that 1-2 breaking ball. Put himself right back in this at bat.
Set to deal on 2-2. And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
If you're at the plate right now, you have to realize who's on deck. I guarantee you something's over the heart of the plate. You have to be aggressive in the zone right here.
And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball 4.
Yeah, the pitching coach would hate to go to the bullpen this early in the game, but sometimes you have no choice. On the flip side, he might just get in his face a little bit out there, try to challenge him, wake him up from his funk. Either way, we'll see how it works.
Here's Corey Seager. He's coming off a solo homer in his previous trip.
And that last at-bat when he went deep, he turned around a pretty good fastball. So I'm kind of thinking this guy's a good fastball hitter, so I might want to move that ball up and down and in and out and try not to throw it right down the middle of the plate.
A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. with 2-1. Runners off for second. Strike called. Now the throw down. It is well behind the play. That's an easy stolen base.
Well, this pitcher's out there just trying to get hitters out, and he's having a hard time doing that. So as a base runner, that's a good time to try to steal some bases. He's probably not as focused on controlling the running game as he should be.
Rolled slowly down the third baseline. But the throw will be well late. So a good play, but it's off or not, as that'll be an infield single.
Hey, that's great hustle right there out of the box. Not everybody's getting it right out of the chute from step one, but I have to ask you, Dan, how frustrating executing a pitch and there's an infield knock.
It is, D-Roy. You can read that right off the bat as a pitcher. You can read the angle. You know that that ball is going to be hit on the ground, and you're thinking deep down inside, okay, there's a quick out, and it just wasn't meant to be.
Four runs, seven hits. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
Number three hole hitter up right now. Cleanup guy on deck. Two ball, two strike count. I think pitcher wants to make something happen right here.
The set and the 2-2 and a fastball called strike three, and the side is retired. One for the Dodgers on the solo home run. We played four. It's now a 4-3 Dodger lead. New inning set to get underway, and that brings up the former American League MVP Josh Donaldson. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. There to look it in is Betts, and that's out number one.
Now batter, the designated hitter.
Here's Nelson Cruz now. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Here's a fly ball well hit. Back goes Betts at the track. And this one is gone, a home run. A solo home run from Nelson Cruz. His third home run of this series, as that'll pull him even at 4 apiece.
That's one of those pitches you wish you could take back as soon as it leaves your hand. But guess what? There are no delete or rewind buttons in baseball. That's a mistake, and it was a good job by his opponent to make him pay for it.
To the plate now, Eddie Rosario. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Bellinger's under it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
The batter number 13, second baseman. A-Ray Adrianza.
Digging in the switch hitter, A-Ray Adrianza. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Starts to go around, but the home plate umpire says he held up ball two. And here in just the fifth inning, this will be pitch number 100 here.
Boy, pitch count up near 100 right now, D-Row. And this is when you try to get to a good starting pitcher. Right now, looks like he's running on fumes.
Yeah, the manager's got to get a couple people up in the bullpen right now. One ball hits the gap. They get runners in scoring position. This game could be out of commission.
Hit out towards second. Scooped up. Throw on to Muncy. Gets him. And with that, they'll end the inning. The Twins do come back to level things out thanks to this solo home run. On to the bottom of the fifth. All even now at 4 apiece. Matt Wisler, the right-handed reliever standing 6'3", gets the ball now out of the bullpen.
Matt Wisler.
Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and digging in is the outfielder, Cody Bellinger. That's a foul ball off to the left, and it moves to 1-2. Now the pitch. Inside and a hair low. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes.
Boy, that's one of the toughest pitches to lay off. A hard breaking ball at the back foot. Tough take on a terrific pitch.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Here's a high pop-up. Donaldson shading to his right. One down. Twins are into their bullpen now, as there are the final numbers for their starter. Clearly not the postseason outing he had envisioned.
Well, this one's really easy to dissect. Too many pitches left over the heart of the plate. 3 bombs allowed in this one. He's going to have to do a better job of throwing quality pitches down the road.
One out, nobody on. And he fouls this one off. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Through first and hustling for second. And he'll pull into second with one away.
Just goes to show, if you're going to throw that two-seam fastball away, which I don't think is the best pitch anyway, you better start that thing out of the zone and let it work its way back to the corner. With this one, it started out on the corner, so it leaked back right over the heart of the plate and got whacked.
In now, Kike Hernandez. In the dirt here. Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. He's set. Now the pitch. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Kepler's there for it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are 2 away.
Now back, the third baseman, Justin Turner.
Ready once again, Justin Turner, runner in scoring position with two gone.
Goes to show you how strong this guy is. That wasn't a bad breaking ball that he hit for a home run in that last at bat. That
a swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. Dodgers leave 1. 5 innings complete. This ball game's even at 4-4. Dustin May takes over to start the 6th inning on the mound.
Number 85, Dustin May.
Top half of the 6th about to get started, and next will be the imposing power bat, Miguel Sano. Now the 1-1 pitch. Is a curveball taken low for a ball. Some action in the Dodger bullpen now, as it appears they have both a lefty and a right-hander up and throwing. Three and one. Byron Buxton is on deck. A 3-1 pitch. Is swung on and missed, and that's a full count now. 3 balls and 2 strikes. And he looks at a cold strike 3 as the cut fastball's in there, and that's out number 1. Digging in once again, Byron Buxton. He reached on a fielder's choice previously. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and 2 strikes here.
you have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
Four, four is our score as we play the sixth. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
At the plate now, Max Kepler. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. Now here it comes. To 2-2 now.
I think it's about time to choke up on that bat and get that foot down. He's awfully tardy right now.
Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Line drive snagged on a short hop. Throw on to Muncy gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. Down go the Twins in order. Through five and a half, we're tied at four. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and next to hit is the catcher, Will Smith. Taken up and in for ball two. Now some action out in the Minnesota pen, as it looks like both a lefty and a right-hander are up to throw. Two balls and two strikes now. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Into the box now, Gavin Lux. Tried to crush that ball, and now perhaps needs to shorten up with two strikes. Now the payoff pitch home. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His third home run of this series, as they will take the lead here. It's now a 5-4 ball game. Mookie Betts. And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away.
Nice two-seam fastball there. You don't usually see a lot of swings and misses with that pitch unless it's really moving. So that one must have had some real good late life.
At the plate, Corey Seager. drilled on the ground to short. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Yeah, that hard hit single right there, that's clean. 3 for 4, he's looking locked in.
Stepping in now, Max Muncy. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Looks like this guy's afraid to throw the ball in the strike zone. Gave up that home run earlier in the inning. Needs to get back to being aggressive.
The 2-1 on its way. On a good pitch there, had him stretching to get out there, and it's 2-2 now.
Guess where he's going with this next pitch? Probably a little further outside, see if the fish are still biting.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. One for the Dodgers on the solo home run. The 9-1-2 hitters due up to start the seventh. LA's out in front now, 5-4. 7th inning ready to roll, and now it'll be the catcher, Mitch Garver.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Hit sharply on the ground. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And the throw won't be in time as he'll be able to beat out the recovery throw at first.
Well, nothing earth-shattering about this one. He just didn't finish the play and watch it into his glove. And now they've got the leadoff runner aboard and no outs.
So a runner at first now with nobody out. And that'll bring in Jorge Polanco to hit next. From the belt, kicks and deals. Lifted down the line in left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 1-2 is looked at for ball number two. And he misses this one inside, and that'll run things full, 3-2.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
3-2 pitch. Hot shot down the line. And he tries for the backhand reach at third, but he gets by the glove down the line.
Now's a good time for your pitcher to take a deep breath. He still has the lead, although it probably doesn't feel like it. So he can't worry about how he got into this mess. He just has to figure out how to get out of this mess.
Josh Donaldson digging in now. Not much in the way of productivity from him so far, but he's got a chance to come through here in a crucial spot.
Yeah, it's time now that he has to put the rest of those bats behind him, because none of that matters if he can clutch up when it really counts.
The 1-1 home is swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Nobody out. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. And this is swung on and missed. And boy, they took care of a key man there. One away. So striding in, Nelson Cruz, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield.
That last at bat, he didn't crush that changeup for a home run, but listen, a home run is a home run. This guy's awfully strong, and he can hit it out to any part of the ballpark.
Swing and a miss as he ran that in on him, a ball and two strikes.
I wouldn't be surprised if he used his aggressiveness against him right here.
you're going to get a swing outside the zone, 1-1, might as well fish a little bit further.
The 1-2. Eddie Rosario is on deck. Crowd gets up for the 3-2. One out with the possible tying and go-ahead runs on base here. He takes a look at strike three called, and that's as important as they come there. Two big outs now.
Flat out locked him up with the changeup right there. Usually you're trying for a swing and miss when you throw that pitch in a two-strike count, but clearly he wasn't looking for it, so it's a backwards K for him.
Jake McGee comes on now, and this move looks to be all about playing the matchup here.
Yeah, and I don't think there's any doubt about that, Matt. They want the lefty-lefty matchup, and that's usually the right move, but we'll just have to see how this plays out.
Into the box, Eddie Rosario hit on the ground down the first baseline, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Dodger bullpen does its job. On now to the bottom of inning number 7. It's the Dodgers 5 and the Twins 4. Tyler Duffy gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home 7th. Last half of the 7th here, and that'll bring forward Cody Bellinger. Swing and a line drive, but just fouls as he just misses extra bases.
I think for every player, for every former player, that swing right there is the reason we need to extend the netting without question. Want the fans to be safe.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning. One gone now in the LA 7th, and up next, the center fielder, A.J. Pollock. Strikes him out as well, so make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
Up next to the doctor.
Standing in, Kike Hernandez. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch.
I got 3-1. 3 balls, 1 strike.
Strike two called, and it's full 3-2. And he struck him out. So a fine inning here as he strikes out this side in order. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Game four rolls along. We're back after this. Blake Trinan has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the 8th.
Number 49.
Roger. standing in, Eury Adrianza, career against Blake Treinen. He's hitless in three at-bats. Now the 1-1 pitch. Pretty well hit. Deep down the line in right, but that's back into the seats. Foul. Treinen primarily attacks hitters with his sinker, but not your typical sinker. He throws it much harder than most.
He's a hard guy to get elevation on. In a day and age where a lot of hitters are looking to lift and separate and get the ball in the air, he has some good sink, not great sink, but he makes hitters hit the ball on the ground, and when he's on, you'll see a lot of ground balls.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch-out. Eury Adrianza becomes the first out of the inning. Blake now, Miguel Sano. Now a swing as he stays alive as this is fouled back right off the catcher's arm. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
Luis Arraez will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number two, Luis Arraez.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2. Lifted the other way out to left center. In there, a base hit.
Now back, right fielder, Matt Kepler.
Standing in now, Max Kepler. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Two out with the man at first. Again, another foul ball. Another full count pitch home, and he missed with it. Ball four, so that means now the potential tying run will move into scoring position at second.
Well, he made quick work of the first two guys this half inning, getting two quick outs, but then he gives up a base hit and now the walk. We'll see if he has it in him to draw the line in the sand and get out of this.
So striding forward now, Mitch Garver. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. One and two to the Twins catcher. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. And that one misses badly. It's ball two. Big spot. Two out. Possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. And that's into the corner, a foul ball and right. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this has been the at-bat of the night so far.
Of the stretch, the 3-2 home, high and deep down the left field line, And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Big spot. Two out, possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. And they have taken the lead. So a three-run blast to left center as they've taken a two-run lead. Game out of the pen looking for the final out here in the top of inning number eight.
Number 52, Pedro.
Into the box now, Jorge Polanco. 2-1 now to the Twins leadoff man. Three runs already home here. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
The hitter was dug in looking for something to hit, but he would have needed a telephone pole to hit that thing way out of the zone.
So it's a runner at first with two men out. And here's Donaldson. Even at a ball and a strike, here's the pitch. A runner on first with two away. Popped him up. Muncy over to his left, and the inning is over. But the Twins do strike for three, all coming on this three-run home run. Bottom of the eighth coming up. It's the Twins 7 and the Dodgers 5. Trevor May is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. Jake Cave is into the ball game now as he assumes duties in center field.
Now playing center field, number 15.
Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that'll give way to the third baseman, Justin Turner.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. And he makes good contact there, but this is going to find the stands foul down the right field line. The 2-2.
Three balls, two strikes.
Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they'd gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on and get that tying run to the plate.
Turner swings, and it's a very well-hit ball to left. And that'll get down out there for extra bases. And it's a good start to the inning for the Dodgers on the leadoff double.
Now that's what you call a clutch piece of hitting. Down two runs, he puts himself in scoring position and brings the tying run to the plate. We'll see what they do with the base open here. This one's getting interesting.
In now, Will Smith. Slow roller out to short. Fielded cleanly. And a good throw gets him one gone.
Now batter, number nine.
So a crucial moment here in standing in, Gavin Lux. But a single here could reduce the deficit to only one.
Yeah, now that last one wasn't exactly a tape measure shot. But listen, a home run is a home run. I know a lot of pitchers, they call that a wall scraper in his last AB. But listen, it counts as a home run nonetheless.
And that's going to fall for a base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away.
Boy, so frustrating as a pitcher. You make a quality pitch on the inside half of the plate right there. Try to bust him in, D-Row, and he fights it off the other way.
Yeah, you tip your hat to the pitcher right there. He executed his pitch, but nice job by the offensive player fighting. It doesn't matter what it looks like. A knock's a knock.
Now back to the top of the Dodgers order. Digging in, Mookie Betts. And he's got runners at the corners here with only one gone. Runners are at first and third, one away. To 1-2 now.
You're lucky if you get one pitch a night right down the middle. Cannot be late on that fastball.
And now a slider in there for a called third strike, and there are two gone now.
That's a big strikeout there with the tying run over at first base. Now with two outs, it becomes a lot more difficult to manufacture that guy home. Probably need a ball in the gap to give him a chance.
Sergio Romo trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away. At the plate, Corey Seager. Two balls and two strikes to Corey Seager. Runners on first and third, two away. Slapped hard the opposite way. And that'll get down out there near the wall. One run is scored. Here's a second runner around third. He'll score, and the Dodgers have drawn even. It's now a 7-7 game.
Well, there are base hits, but then there are big base hits, D-Roll. This one's getting late. That is a huge 2-RBI base hit to tie things up.
Yeah, Dan, in the late innings, the pressure gets higher. It's who can control their emotions. And from an offensive standpoint, that's a nice job of taking a deep breath and coming through for the team.
Stepping in now, Max Muncy. Here's a swing and a miss at the off-speed pitch. It's a full count now, 3-2. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. There's ball four.
That was a great battle right there. He tried to get him to chase, but he laid off some really tough pitches and got a walk. Got to tip the cap to the batter that time.
So here's Cody Bellinger. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at bat.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Fouled off. The 2-2 outside and a full count, 3-2.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here. So whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
Ready with the payoff pitch. Good swing on a tough pitch, and he'll stick around to see another one. Payoff pitch on its way. And he'll hang in here as he reaches to foul this one away. Out of the stretch, the 3-2 home. popped him up. Adrianza waits on it. He hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around to score. So two runs on three hits, no errors, and a couple of men left. We're through eight full here in game four, and we are tied 7-7. Chris Taylor remains in the game playing third after entering the game as a pinch hitter in the previous half inning. Set to start the ninth in this one, and digging in is the veteran DH, Nelson Cruz. The 2-1 is offered at and missed. He chased it for strike two. And it's fouled away. And he fouls this one off.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
Swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
Boy, that's the best pitch in baseball right there with two strikes. That elevated fastball. Every hitter thinks that, hey, they can do something with that. But most of the time, you get the result that you saw right there. A big swing and a miss and another strikeout.
Into the box, Eddie Rosario. 3-1 now. Bases are empty. One man out. And the count will be full. Now the 3-2 pitch. On the ground and right at the shifted infielders. He's got it. And that's the second out.
Now batting, the second baseman, A-Ray Adrianza.
The next twin up, Aure Adrianza, struggling so far in this one and looking to erase his 0-for-4 ball game right here. Ready with the 1-1. Breaks his bat as this one's popped up. Throw on to Muncy, gets him, and with that, they'll end the inning. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. The Dodgers with a chance to walk it off as we go to the last of the night. All set for the bottom of the ninth, and that'll bring up A.J. Pollock. Here comes the 1-1. Hard ground ball. Defense played him perfectly. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
Now back, left fielder, DK Hernandez.
Stepping in, DK Hernandez. Looking to change his fortunes here. 0-for-4 with two strikeouts so far in the game. Him, and he goes down on strikes for the third time. Now with the play, Chris Taylor. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Bases are empty here with two men out. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Here's fires the 2-1. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Around first, he's digging for second. And the possible winning run is in the second base. He's got a two-out double.
Hey, that's a nice piece of hitting right there. Two-out base knock to put the winning run on base. Let's see if someone can catch a gap and end this thing.
So now to the plate, Will Smith. Swing and a miss on a pitch outside. 1-2 now.
That's a really nice thing about pitching with the base open. You can work out of the strike zone a little bit more and try to get a guy to chase your pitch just like that one.
Now the 1-2 pitch. Now here's a ground ball up the middle and into center field for a base hit. And this gets right through him, and that may be a run. And the postseason magic is there for them one final time as they walk off to win the World Series. Santa Maria.
Heroes are born in October, and you can add another name to that one right here as he finds a way to win this thing with a dramatic walk-off. Wow! What a clutch at bat, what a game, and what a World Series.
Like this in a series clinching game. Guys, he's our top player of the game.
Yeah, you said it, Matt. This is where it matters the most. People are going to be talking about this performance here for the rest of his life. He was on the big stage for everyone to see, and he was the difference maker in the series victory.
Back now on the show as we take you through a few of the sights and sounds of the final game of this World Series. Down on the field, we'll get a chance to watch the presentation of the Commissioner's Trophy to the new world champs.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers, 8 runs on 15 hits. 1 error, they left 9 men on base. For the Twins, 7 runs, 8 hits. No errors, they left 7 men on base. Time of the ball game, 4 hours and 16 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance, awesome. 56,000. The Dodgers thank you for attending tonight's game And as you leave Dodger Stadium, we remind you to please drive home safely.